Hi, welcome to FielDHub. In this video, I'll show you how to make an experiment with an Alpha Lattice design. We can do this in both the FielDHub app and the FielDHub package for R. We'll start with the app. To begin, in the FielDHub app, click Lattice Designs in the top bar and select Alpha Lattice from the dropdown. The resulting screen is similar to the other designs in FielDHub, with the input panel on the left side and the output screen on the right side. Starting at the top of the input panel, we have an option to import a list of entries by uploading a CSV file. This file needs to consist of two columns, one with the header entry and the other with the header name. The values in the entry column can be any set of consecutive positive numbers. In this example, we'll not upload a list of entries. Below that, we have an option to import the number of treatments for our experiment. For this example experiment, we'll use 60 treatments, so we input that in the box. Next, we have an input to set the number of replications in the experiment. We'll keep the default value of 3 reps for our example. Next, we can set the number of plots per incomplete block in the design. The set of options is automatically generated based on the number of treatments. They're all numbers that divide the number of treatments. We'll choose 6 for this example. Then, like many of the other designs on FielDHub, we may run this experiment over multiple locations, which we input in this next box. We'll keep it at 1 for this example. After this, we have the same options for customization as we do in the other designs, like plot order layout, starting plot number, location, and seed number. We'll set starting plot number to 1001 and seed number to 100. Now, we have defined the Alpha Lattice design we want to run on our experiment, so we can click the Run button. Once we click Run, we can see the field layout defined by the inputs we gave. Since we set input number of plots per iBlock to 6, we can see 10 iBlocks of 6 plots each, or 10 iBlocks over each of the 3 reps we defined. If we set the number of plots per iBlock to a different value, say 10, and then hit Run, we can see that the yellow lines delineating the incomplete blocks move, making 6 iBlocks of 10 plots in each rep. If we increase the number of full reps to 4 and click Run, we can see that there's an additional layer of 6 iBlocks added. We can also choose to arrange the reps side by side instead of stacked by changing the reps layout in the bottom panel from vertical stack panel to horizontal stack panel. Next to this setting, we have a set of layout options, the number of which are generated by the number of treatments and iBlocks. Here are a couple of the layouts. Next to this box is an option to change the location displayed, if there are multiple locations. We can save the displayed layout with the Excel button near the top of the page. On the second tab, we can view the field book, which contains all the information about each plot in the experiment, including the treatment in the plot and the rep and iBlock that the plot is in. We can save the field book as a CSV file with the Save My Experiment button at the bottom of the input panel. We can create an identical experiment in R using the Alpha Lattice function in the FieldHub package. To start, open an R terminal. First, we specify that we're using the FieldHub package with library FieldHub. We'll save this to an object called alpha. So, we write alpha is defined as alpha lattice. For the arguments of the function, we have t equals 60 for number of treatments, r equals 3 for number of replications, k equals 6 for number of plots per incomplete block, l equals 1 for one location, plot number equals 1001 for starting plot number, location names equals Fargo for location name, and seed equals 100. When we hit enter, we save an identical experiment to the object alpha. We can view the plot and field book of this experiment in R as well. To view the field book, we use the dollar sign operator on the object alpha, as in alpha dollar sign fieldbook, which gives the following output. We can also plot the experiment with the plot function, as in plot alpha, which gives the following output. We have the same options for layout of the plot as in the app, with the arguments stacked being either vertical or horizontal for layout of the reps, and layout being a number to select the layout options, usually from 1 to 5 or 6, depending on the parameters. For instance, we can change the plot with plot, alpha, stacked equals vertical, layout equals 3, which gives us a different layout for the plot.